Fly by Eddie Kane Jr.'s channel.
Let me see. Eddie Kane Jr. Eddie Kane Jr. Eddie Kane Jr. Why that sound familiar? Get over here.
Eddie Kane Jr., I'm letting you know right motherfucking now. Do not record my live and go put it on no YouTube channel. And I'm not playing.
Ain't no secret. Should do Eddie Kane Jr. Like, share, subscribe. If you subscribe to me, leave a comment down the post. I'm a sub back to you. Rip. That's what I'm about. Hey, my people. Y'all know why we here. Man, so you renegades, we all know. Our dude, Dirkio Smirkio, man. You know he knocked. You know what I'm talking about? But, always a but. 3 days ago, on Little Dirk's YouTube page, a video was uploaded, you know what I'm saying? And it's an interesting title of the video. The video is entitled, We Slid, aka Sly for Vaughn. Like, the timing of this is crazy, you know what I'm talking about? And on there, Dirk, you know what I'm saying? He's on there talking. This just some of the couple of the bars he's talking about on this song. He says, Dirk Cap, he ain't Sly for Vaughn yet, his ass silly. Dirk Cap, he ain't the voice, he just a nigga from the city. Y'all Cap, how I leave my block, I just dropped off the switches. Now this right here, and I know Dirk signed to a major label, but this can only be one of two things in Eddie Kane Jr. opinion. One, the label. As we know, like 6ix9ine was saying, I don't listen to 6ix9ine a lot, but when 6ix9ine was speaking about the industry, I peeped it because I can kind of relate to what he was saying. He had an interview. He was talking about basically like when you sign to that major label, they control your social media. Once you sign your name on that dotted line, they basically got creative control on what you drop, on who you can do features with, on your social media, especially now the social media presence. They want to know everything that you post, and they got to go through, like, you got to get clear. You're not even handling it. In some instances, they got the password. Like, they'll change the password up, like, so you don't even have access to it. Sounds crazy. Actually happens. So did Dirk's label upload Sly for Vaughn? You know what I'm saying? Did they upload that in the midst of this man just getting knocked as being like in a red rum for hire? You know what I'm saying? He doing murder for hire when they're allegedly trying to tie him in not only with Lil Pop, also with FBG Cash. Allegedly, they're trying to tie that in with like a few of the same people, if not all of the OTF5, as they're now known. Not only did the Lil Pop, you know what I'm saying, hit, they also met up with Cash that night, you know what I'm saying? And now the thing is, now, if we go back to Cash's situation with the young lady, they had gotten into a situation with them prior to when Cash was assassinated. There was another situation where there was, you know what I'm saying, lead being sprayed, you know what I'm saying? He escaped that one. Didn't escape the second attempt, you know what I'm saying? So in the midst of all this, them trying to put this on Dirk, where they're trying to say he, you know what I'm saying, he's basically the paymaster, like murder for hire, you know what I'm talking about? Like Murder, Inc., you know what I'm talking about? Like, I'm talking about not the label. I'm talking about back in the day in NYC, they had, you know what I'm saying, the team that like, hey, it was a price given and things were done. You know what I'm talking about? That's the type of time they trying to say Dirk is on. But I digress. The label doesn't care about their artists. They really don't. They just care about the bottom line, the money, you know what I'm saying? They just trying to get revenue in. Now, some people were saying that the video was taken down. I just went and looked at the video. It got uploaded 3 days ago. It's still on Dirk's page. And this is Dirk's official YouTube page. Got like 6.6 million hits on it. You know what I'm talking about? So this is definitely terrible timing, and just let you know that the label don't care, you know what I'm talking about? Or it's two, it's one of his guys. They got the passwords, you know what I'm saying? It's one of his guys who don't really care for this cat, who, like, you know what I'm saying? And it's a lot of, and them the worst ones. The ones who know, you know what I'm saying? They know where the motion detector's at, you know what I'm talking about? They know the password to the alarm. They never gonna set the alarm off because they know the password to the alarm, you know what I'm talking about? Them the ones you gotta watch. And it might have been somebody's secret. We know Dirk was not seeing eye to eye with a lot of 300. A lot of 4-6, you know what I'm saying? Bezu at tour, right before he got knocked, he came together with Bezu, and you know what I'm saying? They made peace and whatnot, Tay Savage and whatnot, but might have been too little too late. Might have had a mole up in the operation who don't care for you, you know what I'm talking about? They care about what you can do for them. You giving them some money. They might have stacked their money or whatever the case may be. It's either the label or it's a hater in your camp. You know what I'm talking about? You got a mole in your camp. You know what I'm talking about? Who just doing stuff like that. And then with Kayla B. Let's take a peek at Kayla B. You know what I'm saying? Like when she was with JoJo World and then with another one of Vine. People he didn't see out of wide with. Peep this. Now, Renegades, I know what y'all gonna say. Kayla B was young when she was hanging around with JoJo and them Brick Squad, 63rd. She was all up through there, you know what I'm saying? She cracking trades, you know what I'm talking about? She owned one, you know what I'm saying? Then, okay, I give y'all that. She was younger. But she just was with Chief Keef, you know what I'm talking about? And Chief Keef and Vine was not seeing eye to eye. Chief Keef to this day has not even acknowledged Vine's passing. He hasn't even said rest in peace or nothing in Vine, for Vine, you know what I'm saying? Just words or a post. Not even words, even a post for Vine, you know what I'm saying? They were not seeing eye to eye. So, Kayla B, you sold Vine crazy. You stand up for him, you out there scrapping with ladies for him, and you go right behind and get, you know what I'm saying, riding old boy wave, you know what I'm saying, with Chief Keef. That's a bad look. And that's where, like, boom, it's all coming, might be coming full circle. When Baylo and granddaughter, aka Mona Lisa, were saying that, like, you were stealing Vine money and that you stole, keyword, key phrase it, when she stole the hard drive. I heard that she had took a hard drive from Vine's crib after he passed and gave it to Dirk. You know what I'm talking about? And Renegades, I'm about to pin a video down there I did where they were talking about Dirk allegedly knocking King Von's mom. Now people are speculating Dirk also knocked Kayla B, gave her some cash and money, you know what I'm saying, allegedly, for King Von's hard drive, you know what I'm saying? You notice on, and I want y'all, I'm not gonna play that song, but go check out Sly for Von on Dirk Page. It's some Von bars on there, you know what I'm talking about? Unheard Von bars, you know what I'm saying? So is this from that hard drive that Kayla B delivered to Dirk, you know what I'm saying? I wish I had that video off YouTube. I think it might've got scrubbed off of YouTube, but it was a video, I think it was like a Ring camera video from Von's house after he passed, when all these dudes running in and out, back and forth, taking stuff from that cat crib, you know what I'm saying? And that's Kayla B, she might have been even before all that, because hey, I'm pretty sure she got the codes to that cat crib. That's his sister, you know what I'm saying? So, and she in your midst, and she up in there. But and this one thing, and I'm gonna let it go with this. Did y'all know, Renegades, that at the time of Von's passing, he was not signed to OTF. He was not an OTF artist. Why? Why would not he sign with Dirk? Dirk put this cat on when he first got out. Him and Bezu did, you know what I'm saying? Beat that body, put some cash in his pocket, you know what I'm saying? Put him on. Why would he not sign with Dirk? And this is prior to, like, him knowing about the industry, or any of them about the 360 deals, how they, you know what I'm saying, how the labels do you, or how, you know what I'm saying, if you sign to somebody, how they can do you. Vine was a smart dude. Memo 600 also didn't sign. He didn't sign that deal with Dirk. They knew Dirk. You know what I'm saying? It was something they knew about Dirk. Dude was out cold, you know what I'm saying? And that's when we go back to Dirk and how he, you know what I'm saying, knocked Von's mom allegedly, knocking Kayla B allegedly, get this car hard drive, and you got access to Von bars, you know what I'm saying? Like, it didn't go to his mama, you know what I'm saying? It went to you. Hence, peep these bars that he got on Sly for Von, you know what I'm saying? It lets you know, like, and that's the one thing, don't sign to no label, you know what I'm talking about? Independent is the route. You can go right now and just do it yourself. Get you, you know what I'm saying, get your SoundCloud, get your YouTube page, get your stuff on Pandora, all that. You don't need no label, man, because they're going to have too much control over you. And they're going to give you that advance, but they don't. You got to read the fine print. You got to pay that back. They want to recoup that, you know what I'm talking about? And they're going to give you all this other stuff. They're going to treat you like Big Red treated the Five Heartbeats. He going to have that list of expenses if you try to leave. That's just how I see it, man. Should do Eddie Kane Jr. You ain't no renegade. Hit that sub button. You want to join us on the low key. Watch these ninjas' mission. Hit that join button. Welcome to the Renegades. Ain't no secret.
Now, if you have any other problems with your royalties and my books, my office hours are from. My office hours are from.